Sadly, they can just Google how to make it. It is known as the mother of Satan, and it's the preferred explosive utilized by ISIS.
FBI agents found the substance terrorists use in this small-town Wisconsin apartment last March. The mysterious bomb maker, Ben Morrow, died in the blast. Investigators found masks, white supremacist materials, a ballistic helmet and vest, plus a cache of weapons in the unit. For the first time, the FBI special agent bomb technician who went inside the apartment describes what he saw.
The destructive power of this explosive is just unfathomable.
He demonstrated how just a fingernail size amount of TATP reacts, saying he didn't feel comfortable using any more because it's too dangerous and unpredictable. Again, that was just half an ounce of TATP. The FBI believes the Beaver Dam bomber had a staggering amount, 6.5 to 11 pounds.
When the initial detonation occurred, it dispersed a lot of this powder all over the apartment. Because the insulation covered it, we didn't know where it ended up going.
Agents decided the only safe answer was to blow up the building and burn it to the ground. Some people lost everything.
I could not have people return back to their apartments and have something happen to them, knowing that we knew fully well that this is a potential problem. It wasn't a thing that anybody wanted to do, but it was one of those things that had to be done.
This is what's left of that Beaver Dam apartment building. Pretty much nothing. It's just a vacant lot with a little bit of grass and some gravel. 8 months later, an FBI bomb tech's still think about what happened here.
Now we're running more and more into people attempting to do their own compositions of various explosives.
While we may never know what Morrow intended to do with the explosives, it was a wake-up call for local bomb techs.
The Beaver Dam incident kind of changed the rules a little bit, and now we're a little bit more cautious than we were to start with.
What kind of changes?
Well, it's the attempt to recognize the signs of IEDs. I was never one for chemistry in school. I hated it, but I've become a chemistry nerd.
Because of what happened here at this sleepy Beaver Dam apartment complex, now FBI agents want to put together a course on IEDs for local police departments so officers know what chemicals to look out for when they show up on scene. In Beaver Dam, I'm Adrian Pedersen, WISN 12 News.